Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby. The road to the 150th running continues, and this time we go to the Fairground Stakes for the Lecomte Stakes. A lot of times the traditional route to the Kentucky Derby, including the Lecomte Stakes, the Risen Star, and the Louisiana Derby. It's going to be Saturday, January the 20th, a mile and a 16th on the dirt, race number 13. It's going to be dark, approaching darkness, and it's going to be the end of a nice 13 race card that does include some nice stakes races. The Risen Star, race number 13. It is a points race on the road to the Kentucky Derby. 10 points to the winner and points all the way down to fifth place. Race number 13 on the Kentucky Derby trail. Let's take a look at the field. Starting off, it did draw a field of 8 horses, and we've got 3 runners coming back from the Gunrunner Stakes, including Next Level. He set the pace, was up there early on in the fast fractions of the Gunrunner Stakes. He was battling for the lead for just a little bit with Track Phantom, who was on the outside, and then Next Level gave away first going into the turn. I think Next Level wants to maybe try to slow down those fractions. I do think he likes the lead. He draws the 1 post position again. Nash was the heavy favorite the last time, 1-5 off the big 97 buyer speed figure at Churchill Downs. He rated a little bit, got a little bit behind the leaders, and made up some ground going into the turn, ended up running an even 3rd place finish. Meanwhile, Tizzy Indy has 6 starts, 1 win at Churchill Downs, going up in class, trying to go a mile and a 16th. Can Group, this is an interesting runner, won the Bourbonette Stakes on the turf at Keeneland. Gonna try dirt here. Mark Cassie does well with some turf to dirt runners. Can Group out of post position number 4. Ethan Energy, on the same day as the Gun Runner, he won a maiden race, the son of Uncle Mo, drew off with a fast win. He did come off the pace, and he was one of the few runners that did come off the pace that day. Ethan Energy out of post position number 5. Lat Long ships in for Ken McPeak from Oaklawn Park, picked up a win last time out. Kind of got a little bit green in the stretch, almost hit the rail, and then as the runner was getting close to him, we kind of drew away late. Track Phantom, the winner of the Gun Runner at 9-2, back-to-back wins. He picked up a win at Churchill Downs, has faced some good runners, and Steve Asmussen sends out this one out of post position number 7. Awesome Road, 5th in the Kentucky Jockey Club Stakes, been working steadily, comes in off the layoff for trainer Brad Cox out of post position number 8, and Awesome Road, 1 of 3 horses for trainer Brad Cox here in the Lecomte Stakes. A good field. You've got 3 runners back from the Gun Runner, Next Level, Nash, and Track Phantom. I think those are all good contenders in this race. You add in Can Group switching from the turf to the dirt, and then you get Awesome Road off the layoff, who probably has a little bit of room to improve. Being by Quality Road, should be a good dirt horse. Top contenders, I think on the betting board, the top 3 runners, probably going to be Nash, Track Phantom, and Ethan Energy. They're going to take most of the money. Will be interesting to see. Nash was 2-5 the last time. Track Phantom 9-2. See if those odds even out, or if the people come back for more of Nash here in this spot. Let's take a look at the race replays, including the 1st and 3rd place finishers from the Gunrunner Stakes. We're going to take a look at Track Phantom and Nash. We're going to go over the race. Starting off at the beginning, Track Phantom is in the outside post, post position number 8. Broke cleanly, comes in, and then he's battling for the lead with Next Level early. They go fast for the half, a sub 47. They kind of spread out on the field, and Nash is a little bit out of his comfort zone. He went wire to wire 2 races ago, had to kind of chase in this race. Then as they approached the turn, Nash slowly made up some ground, and you see Next Level kind of back out of there. On the turn, it looked like Nash still had a chance to maybe take the victory, but Track Phantom really switched leads. Then down the stretch, kind of kicked it in at the 16th pole, and then Nash kind of eased up late. I don't think they were trying too hard once they saw how strong Track Phantom was running on the front end. Now the track late in that day, the last 3 races were won wire to wire on the dirt, so we'll see how that figures this time around. Nash was a little bit against it by laying off the pace, and after going wire to wire, he was more in a chase mode the last time. Meanwhile, Nash 3rd in that Gun Runner. He does have that 97 buyer in his maiden win by Medaglia d'Oro, And does he come off the pace, or does he try to stay a little bit closer to the lead? And Track Phantom, who's worked out steadily since that Gunrunner Stakes, also has to make that decision. He's shown speed in all of his starts. Now, another runner to take a look at is Ethan Energy. Ethan Energy, a maiden win at the Fairgrounds. Let's take a look at that. A nice move, comes from off the pace, then down the stretch, strides out. This was a nice win. He had Lasix that day, first time on Lasix. Had a mid-race move in his prior race, and I think he's improving by Unker Mole. And Ethan Energy finished with a good gallop out in that maiden win. Definitely a contender here, and he'll take some money. I expect him to be about 5 or 6 to 1 in this spot. Another runner to highlight is Lat Long, an Oaklawn Park win. Now, he had the lead. He's on the lead here. Then he kind of shifts out, almost kind of bumped into the rail. This runner comes from behind. He kicks clear late and pulls away. Interesting race. He's faced some good runners. He's been in some big maiden races, and Lat Long ships in here for the long stretch of the Fairgrounds. Ken McPeak trains, and he probably can come a little bit off the pace, although he was near the leaders in that Oaklawn win. Another runner is Can Group, a Keeneland turf win. Here he is coming from way behind. He gets up in the final stride. He's got to go turf to dirt for Mark Cassie. Has a little bit of a pedigree for the dirt and a closer in this race. The running style and the pace analysis does favor a closer. Not sure he has that dirt kind of class, but the price will be right on Can Group if you want to go a little bit with a little bit of a price. Now, the 6 furlong pace, I see Track Phantom on the lead, but I think closer right away is going to be Nash. He's not going to let him get up by 5 or 6 lengths. Lat Long, I think, is going to lay a little bit back, and next level with that one post position, he may have to send out of there. Awesome Road is going to be mid-pack off the layoff, and Can Group, I think overall it's going to be a fast pace. It's going to favor off the pace runners. So we'll see if Nash is on the lead, Track Phantom's on the lead, and maybe what Awesome Road and Can Group can do from off the pace. The big questions: Nash, does he show speed? Track Phantom goes for the hat trick. Can he slow down those fractions early? And Ethan Energy going up in class. Those are some of the things that you need to look at when you look at this race, as well as Can Group going turf to dirt. My top selection in the Lecomte Stakes, I'm going to go with Nash. You know, the last time out I went with Track Phantom. I thought he had a little bit of a speed edge. I think Nash didn't try that hard down the lane that last time. I think he wants to be closer to that pace. Exactas, I'm going to play over Track Phantom and Ethan Energy. I think those are the three main contenders. Maybe Lat Long if you want to throw in another price. In my pick fives, I think you want to stick mainly with Nash and Track Phantom. The road to the 150th Kentucky Derby continues. We got the Southwest Stakes next week, the Wither Stakes, Robert Lewis, and Holy Bull on February 3rd. Don't forget my Saturday notebook. People wanted my selections for these big racing days. It's going to be free. Just sign up in below in the description. There's a link for the racing notebook. It'll be about 2,000 words. I'll have some top picks, some recommended wagering strategies, kind of some of my notes on these stakes races. The Lecomte Day, it'll come out after the scratches, about 20 minutes before that first race on Saturday, next Saturday. The Triple Crown Prospectus, if you want all the latest news and notes on the Triple Crown, hit subscribe in the description below. Who do you like in the Lecomte Stakes? I'm taking Nash. Leave a comment. And remember, Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.